just a quick video this evening. This module turned up today, and it's six capacitors, and these are super capacitors, and I'm waiting to see if I can find the information here. And these are 2.7 volt, 120 farad capacitors. So they're not the biggest of super capacitors, and they may not even have that capacity in them at all, but they're built onto this module, and on the bottom we can see some control circuitry, and we can see these resistors here, and I think we've got a little voltage sensor or comparator, something like that, and a transistor of some description, and we can switch in these resistors, presumably if these capacitors get over their 2.7 maximum voltage, or perhaps it might be slightly higher. These resistors are switched in across the capacitor, and they'll bring the voltage down of the single capacitor. So this is a capacitor management system. Now, it was Julian Eilert who pointed me in the direction of this module here, but I have heard of Dacian from Electrodacus. He was using supercapacitors to test his lithium-ion solar charge controller, and the reason for that is they charge up and discharge much faster than batteries do. So with 2.7 volts in each capacitor, well, this can take a maximum of 16 volts, and the listing claimed on eBay it's a 1 farad capacitor, and who am I to doubt that? But something else turned up today, and I wasn't intending to use them together, if I'm honest, but of course now they've both arrived on the same day, well, it makes perfect sense. Now this IMAX B6 clone, it is a clone, will charge lead acid batteries, and that's effectively what I've got here. So let's turn this on, and it's in LiPo at the moment. Well, we don't want that, so lead acid there, select that. We're going to try, let's see if we can do it as high as 4 amps. 12 volt battery, yes please. There we go, we've got 4 amps going into these capacitors, and you can see it's charging incredibly quickly, 13 volts already. We started at 8, so in 17, 18 seconds we're up to 14.7 volts, and the current is dropping away, so I've been able to charge this bank up to 14.7 volts in less than 30 seconds. And there it is done. How do we stop that? There we go. And there it is done. So when we're checking solar charge controllers, the fact that this can charge up really quickly is really useful, and presumably we should be able to discharge it pretty quickly as well. I think 1 amp's the maximum. Let's see what happens. And there we are. So it's coming down, 1 amp load across these capacitors, and we're down to 14 volts already. So this is going to take a bit longer. But these two are really useful together, and I'm looking forward to playing with this capacitor a bit more. So there we are then, a super capacitor module that acts like a lead acid battery, useful for solar charge controller testing and that sort of thing, and testing chargers, I guess, and discharging circuits. So this is going to probably feature in quite a few of my videos. So thanks for watching, hopefully you enjoyed this little quick video from me. Please subscribe if you haven't already, and give us a thumbs up if you can. And before we go, everybody wants to see me short the output, don't they? Oof. Pack a bit of a punch, these. Thanks for watching.